Good evening, and on behalf of my Retired Life Foundation, we welcome you to this
and referring. So I don't know how, and me not being at my own residence. So let's see how we can catch up. So you are in you are at Chennai, right?
This edition of our program on Twitter, you know, we started about if you remember, we started about 3 months before our digital initiative. And every month we have been doing one or two programs on the various platforms, various uses, various aspects of the digital technology, as senior citizens may not be aware of many of them. And it's always good to listen to the younger people on these topics, because they are much more ahead of us as far as the technology is concerned. So therefore, this particular session will be anchored by two young students, young promising MBA students from ITM Business School, Kharghar, Nidhi and Sanchita. They'll be taking us through the basics of Twitter, you know, because Twitter is happens to be one of the most popular microblogging sites in the world. So they'll be taking us through this very exciting journey of the Twitter. Nidhi and Sanchita, the floor is open to you, please.
Thank you so much, sir, for the warm welcome. And I am Nidhi Nabani.
And I'm Sanchita Srivastav.
We're going to take over the session. We are from ITM Business School, Department of Digital Marketing and Transformation, and we'll be teaching you ahead a basics on Twitter. So I'll be presenting my screen for the same. So we'll be starting with Twitter, a basic introduction to Twitter. What is Twitter and how we should go about it, and how do you make ID onto your Twitter, and how to tweet, and what all you can do using Twitter. So moving further, Sanchita would like to continue.
So first we will start with what is Twitter. So Twitter is an online social networking service that enables users to send and read short messages called tweets. So basically, anything that you post on Twitter are called tweets. Registered users can read and post tweets from their accounts. So once you make an account into Twitter, you are a registered user and you can see tweets from other people's account as well. Tweets can contain words, photos, videos, and links, which we will tell you when we will show you the live example of how to create a Twitter account and how to tweet. We will also tell you how you can attach photos, videos, and links with your tweets. So the character limit is 280 characters. So remember, if you post something, the limit has to be 280. The most common length of a tweet is 33 characters. Then historically, only 9% of tweets hit Twitter's 140 character limit. Now it's 1%. So that said, Twitter did some impact from the doubling of character. Therefore, from 140, now it is 280. And Twitter has seen more number of registered Twitters once they have increased the character limit. So moving on, what are Twitter terminologies? So a tweet, as I already said, the message you post and send out to your followers is called a tweet. So now what is retweet? A tweet that you forward to your followers that always retains original content. So sometimes it happens that you like someone else's tweet and you want it in your profile. So for that, you have to use an option called retweet, which means that the tweet is copied from someone else. Then there's @. The @ sign is used to call out usernames in tweets or mentions. So if you want to mention someone in your tweet, your colleague or someone from some other industry, you have to use @ and then the username. Then the word, then #. So any word or phrase immediately preceded by the # symbol. The # will also be explained to you once you create a Twitter account.
Okay, so now I'll be starting with the basics of getting started. So first is creating a profile. So for that, I'll be going further with the live example of how to create a Twitter account. So I hope my screen is visible to everyone, the Twitter screen of create an account. Okay, so you have to just type it twitter.com, or else if you don't have laptop right now, you can also download an app called as Twitter. So now am I going fast or it's the speed is fine?
If you can, we would like you to do this side by side with us, so yeah. That if you are stuck in any step, we will help you.
So moving further, I'll be teaching you about how to create a Twitter account, and simultaneously it would be really good if you do it together, so that if you're facing any difficulties, we can help you out right there. So for creating an account, so suppose my name is Neeti Namani and I want Neeti Namani only to be my Twitter name. So I'll just type it down, Neeti Namani. Okay, and your username can be up to 50 characters. So you can see the limit over here. And if you don't want to use your phone number, then you can also use your email ID. So for here, you can type your email ID. So suppose I'm going with my email ID. So it would be. So now, even now, if you want to go for a date of birth, so you have to just put in your date of birth. I'll just put my date of birth. I hope everything is clear till now, that we are going with the name, the email ID. If you want, you can use your phone number also, and the date of birth. After this, you have to click on next. So here you always have to click on this particular checkbox, because it personalizes your experience. So that is why the technology, the privacy settings and everything. After this, the next part. So sign up. So this is my name, the email ID that I want to use for my Twitter account, and my birth date. So now I'll be signing up. So Twitter sends you a verification code. So if you're using a phone number, you'll get it on your phone that it has a text. And if you're using an email ID, you'll get the verification code on your email ID. So I'll just type it down, my verification code. And then next. So now you have to put in a 8-character password. So it can, you can just put a random password that which you remember, and make sure it contains numbers also and some symbols also, because it helps you for privacy issues. So my password is showing it's perfect. So I can move further. So now it shows you to pick a profile photo. So you can just click over here, and whatever photo you want to put it as, you can use that particular photo. Suppose I'll just click on ITM Business School campus photo. So this will be my profile photo as of now, but it is always advisable to keep your photo itself, and a professional one is more advisable, like someone in formals, and it could be a traditional dress also. So I, just for an example, I'm keeping ITM Business School campus as the profile photo right now. And now comes the bio. This will be explained by Sanchita.
So for bio, you have to introduce yourself and you have to mention your interest. So for example, Nidhi and I are an aspiring digital marketer. So Nidhi will write aspiring digital marketer. Then also your interests. For example, Nidhi is a trained dancer. So Nidhi will write trained dancer. Then she loves playing badminton. So she can write badminton. So now why is your bio important? So for example, if I am on Twitter and I want to search for people with the same interest, so I will go on the search term and write badminton. So there I can find the people of the same interest and I can follow them and I can see their tweets. So that is why your bio is very important. For example, if you are a co-founder of some company, you can write co-founder of dash dash company. If you are author, you can write author of dash dash book. So this is how your bio works. So next.
Yeah, so also you can also mention, like sometimes it happens, you mention entrepreneur or a businessman.
Yeah.
So you can also mention simultaneously, or some NGO you're tied up with. You can do that also. I'm director. So anything that is of your interest and what you are currently doing should be mentioned on your bio.
So now, which languages do you speak? So you have to select the languages you speak. So we will select just English and Hindi.
There are a lot of options as well.
Yeah. So like, for example, if you select Gujarati, so you will see tweets that are Gujarati in that are written in Gujarati. So, and if it's Malayalam, so you will see tweets that are written in Malayalam. So it depends whichever languages you know, you can select.
So all the languages are here. So if you see, there is Chinese, Dutch, Chinese, French, German, everything is there. So for now, we'll be just going for English and Hindi. And if you want to go ahead, you can choose anything, Marathi or Kannada itself.
So now, these are the topics that you are interested in. So for example, you are interested in sports. So you can select cricket and football. So there are various options like entertainment, technology, business and finance. In entertainment, so in entertainment, you'll get subtopics also like Indian actors, Bollywood actors, DC Extended Universe. There must be a politics related topic also. Yeah, so like news. So now in news, you can select Uttar Pradesh, Maharashtra, West Bengal, like the region wise news. Then there's careers. So there are many more, there are many options and you can select whichever option you are interested in. So what this will do is, like, for example, if you have selected news and then Maharashtra, so that anything that is happening in Maharashtra will be shown to you in Twitter as well. So now next. So now these are just suggestions for you to follow. For example, we are a digital marketer and there's a very well known name as Neil Patel. So we can follow Neil Patel, or there are options that are given like Narendra Modi. You can select Narendra Modi. Then there's Joe Biden. Then BCCI. So these are few people that you might be interested to follow.
Like actors also, like Amitabh Bachchan or Elon Musk, the Tesla entrepreneur. So if you follow such kind of people, so obviously Narendra Modi, Amitabh Bachchan, Elon Musk, and the top stars and the top politicians are always on the suggested you to follow because they are trending on Twitter a lot and they tweet a lot. So for now, I'll just follow these five people and we'll be moving ahead. So I'll be skipping the turn on notifications right now, because if you keep on turn on notifications, your phone will start, you know, ringing continuously about the notification that this person has tweeted or something is going on Twitter. So this it's better to skip notifications. And yeah, so now here is the screen. This will be your whole layout of Twitter. So the search bar is over here on the right hand side, that you can see if you want to suppose search a person. So if you're going for Akshay Kumar instance, you can just type Akshay Kumar. So you'll see this is a verified account and it's definitely of Akshay Kumar. So if you want, you can go click on that particular profile, and here is the follow button. So if you click on follow, you'll follow that person, and whatever Akshay Kumar tweets, you'll be able to see. So for now, I'm following him. Now I'll just go to the home page. Is this going perfectly fine? Are there any queries? So,
if somebody has a query, they can ask. Unmute and you can ask. They can go ahead, please.
Okay, so moving further. So now we'll be talking about how to tweet. So there are two options that are available on how to tweet. So if you see the what's happening part, you can use this option also. Or if you see on the left hand side, there is a tweet option. So let's go with tweet option first. So if you click on tweet, a dialog box will get open. So now I'll show how do you use Twitter and what all you can type. Suppose you just want to type about the daily, what is your opinion or something like that. If you want to create a poll, so what is your opinion on proposed farmers bill? So I'll just put a question over here, and if I want, I can put a poll here. So what would be the choice? I agree with it, suppose, and I disagree with it. So there are two options that you can add, and also if you want, you can add a third option as well. So that's optional, but at least two options are mandatory, like yes, no, or third option can be a maybe also. So now poll length. So how many days you want to create this poll? So it can be for 4 days, 5 days, 6 days, or a week. So if I want to go for a 6 days, so it would be 6 days. So here you can select hours also. If I want to go for 23 hours and minutes also. So how many minutes I want to choose. So 59 minutes. So here, this is how you create a poll. And then if here you can change the settings also, that you want everyone to reply or only the people you follow. Like suppose I have already followed the 5 people. So if you want only those 5 people to, you know, answer the poll, and only people you mention. Mention, I'll show it to you right now. How do you mention people? So here, if you see, if I want to mention someone, I'll just write @ and Narendra Modi, suppose. So I'll just click on Narendra Modi, and he's tagged on this particular poll, and it's basically he'll be able to see that how like this is the poll that is going on. And now I'll be going further with hashtag. So now you just have to put hashtag, and if you want farmers bill to be your hashtag, you just have to type farmers bill. So if it's trending, it will always show us that show it as an option. So you just have to click. And now, so
what this hashtag will help you is, if someone goes and search hashtag farmer bill, so your tweet will appear on their screen. So this is how hashtag can help you.
It also helps you to generate more reach for your tweet. So if you want, you can mention different types of location also, like suppose Mumbai or Delhi, or if you want, you can go for opinion also, because it's related, the poll is related to opinion. So if you see, there is opinion hashtag already used, so you can. So it helps your tweet to reach to more and more people on a daily basis. So for this, I just have to tweet now. So I'll just tweet. So Twitter verifies your account continuously, that are you a robot or not. So you just have to click on that particular thing. Yeah. Yeah. So now we were talking about the tweets. So suppose I'll just write a random tweet, that what is your opinion? So I just want to tweet, and for adding a photo, you just have to click here, that is a media, or even if you want to add a video, you just have to click on media. So if I click on media, so whatever photos currently I have on my laptop, it will be shown. So again, if I'm going for ITM Business School campus, I just have to click on it, and the photo is here. And now we can also schedule our post, that what time your post should go live. So you just have to schedule that today, March day 13, year 2021, and which hour you want the post to go live. Suppose I'm talking about 12th hour. So now currently I can't schedule this post because it's past that. So I just have to do it in the morning. So it's very efficient. So if I click on day 14th, that is 14th of March 2021. So on 8th hour, this minute, my post will get live. So I don't want to confirm as of now because I don't want to schedule the post. So after you have your also on what's happening, also you can use that it as a search bar. Your also you can write that what question or what tweet you want to go for. And Twitter always has the algorithm of choosing the characters. So if you go beyond 280 characters, as previously mentioned by Sanchita, Twitter will give you a pop-up that your particular tweet is more than 280 characters. So what is your opinion on politics, suppose? So I just want to tweet it right now. So I'll just click on
tweet. Excuse me.
Yes, sir.
How do we know, make sure that the person to whom you are trying to tweet something is reading that? Suppose you have complained something about it.
Correct.
So you are traveling in a train and you have some problem and you write a tweet to Suresh Prabhu.
Yeah.
How do we know that Suresh Prabhu will read it and take necessary action on that?
So all we can do is guesswork, because there are a lot of people tweeting and tagging him on Twitter, right? On a daily basis.
Yes.
So it's just a guesswork that he might see it or he might not. So it's not necessary that the person will see it, because it's not because Suresh Prabhu is obviously a big person and his Twitter account would be managed by his manager. So because he's busy with other tasks also. So it's not necessary that he'll see your post immediately. He can see it after a month also. So it's better to tag them if you're having a problem. People also will support you regarding the same. So.
Yeah, I was saying, say the same point. Yes, sir. So what you can do is you have to tag him for sure, but you can also ask your followers or people who are seeing your tweet to retweet your tweet or to comment and tag that person. So
no,
maybe this, yeah.
Now, my point was that you have a problem and you want it to be solved. Now, if Suresh Prabhu doesn't see it, then the problem doesn't get solved, isn't it?
Correct, sir. But
so that,
how do I make sure?
Because many times we see that the fellow tweets and within 5 minutes action is taken.
Correct.
So how is that possible, actually?
So, sir, again, it's luck and guesswork, because your technology, people tag him on a day-to-day basis. Every hour he's being tagged, or every minute, suppose. So it's not necessary. So what we can do is you can tag him, ask your friends or family members to, you know, retweet that particular tweet that you have been sharing and tag him. So if that person sees that he's been tagged in multiple comments, or multiple posts, he'll probably reply to your post and he'll take an immediate action for the same.
Okay. Thank you.
No problem, sir. So this is the tweet that I have been posted right now. That is, what is your opinion on politics? So if I want to reply to this particular tweet, I just have to click here and I can reply, or because it's me only who is replying to the tweet, it would go as an another tweet, but that option is generally used as reply. So if you want to comment, you just have to go on this particular part. Now for liking that particular tweet, you just have to click like over here. And if you want to retweet my tweet, so now if Sanchita wants to retweet this, so she can use this option, the retweet option here, as retweet. So, and also if I want to delete the tweet that I have just posted due to some error or something, so I just have to click on the three dots and I have to just delete the tweet. So it's this simple. You just have to like, retweet or comment. And again, so the query that you asked, so for that, you just have to, you know, multiple times tag that particular person using @ so that a particular person sees this, and ask your family and friends to retweet that particular post. So it is helpful for you also and the public. So now Sanchita will be further explaining us about the profile part.
So yes, so if in case you have skipped it first time, so you can still add profile picture. So for that, you have to go to profile, then edit profile. And there you have the option to add a photo. So you have to click on it and then you can choose whatever photo you want. Choose anything. And then click on apply. Then you can also upload your cover photo from here using the same steps, add photo and then select one photo and apply. You can also edit your bio from here. Yeah, if you want to edit your bio, you can do it.
Suppose I'm just writing founder of XYZ company. So mention the company name, so it's helpful for you also. And you can also mention the location.
Yeah, for like Nidhi can write Mumbai. And then if you happen to have a website, you can also mention your website URL.
So for instance, I'm just going with the ITM website. So that is itm.edu.
And then now, you have to hit save. So yeah, the changes will be shown.
Yeah. So now talking about more about the explore part. So if I click on the explore, so if I want someone, if I want to search Sanchita, if she's there on Twitter or not. So just I'll write Sanchita. So I see that Sanchita Srivastava is there on Twitter and her username is Anchi Shriv12. So for that, I'll just visit her profile and click on follow. So similarly, as we had mentioned that interest plays a huge role on explore part. So if you want, as I'm interested in badminton, so if I'm searching for people related to badminton who have interest in badminton, so here comes a lot of, you know, Twitter accounts that are related to badminton, like Badminton Talk or Badminton England. So your next Europe and everything. And if I want to, you know, further see that what all posts have badminton included in them, so just have to click hashtag badminton and Twitter will show us all the relevant posts that are related to badminton. So suppose Badminton England and badminton updates and so on. So if, even if I want to go for suppose politics, so I'll just go for politics right now. So politics, if you click on politics here, so you will see the latest post on politics that this Kim Page has used politics as one of the hashtags on her post. And similarly, Savvy Saps. So you can, and if you want to search a person on a particular Twitter account, so you just have to write the name of the person, that is suppose Rahul Gandhi. So yeah, you see the you see Rahul Gandhi's profile and you see it's verified also. So again, you just have to follow the same process that you just have to click on Rahul Gandhi's profile. And if you want to follow Rahul Gandhi, you just have to click follow. So this. Created, ask your friends and family members to follow you. So it's you will also get followers for the same. So if I want
also hashtag can help you to search any trending topics. Like right now Zomato is trending. I hope you all know the incident. So you can see people's opinion about Zomato incident. So for that you have to write hashtag Zomato. Yeah. Click on any hashtag. Zomato delivery guy. So there you can see what people, yeah. So there you can see opinions about people for Zomato delivery person. So that is how hashtag will help you.
So this is the Zomato case that is currently going on. So what people do is, you know, whatever trending things are happening in and around the world, the first thing they go is tweet about it. So they tweet their opinions, and if they are facing any issue related to something, so they tweet, because they know that the sooner or later the problem will get solved and people will support them if the problem is really genuine. So now if you want to message someone on Twitter, so you have a message tab on the left hand side. So yeah, if I want to message someone on Twitter, I just have to click on message and then go to the search bar. And if I'm searching for Sanchita again, so Sanchita, so yeah, I just have to click on start a conversation. Then I'll just go for Sanchita. So now as Sanchita is not my friend right now, so I can't message. So I'll just go for a random person. Or if I want to, you can't, yeah. So if you want to message, you can't message top people like Narendra Modi and all. Their message notifications are off completely. Because if they get regular messages on Twitter, then obviously the account will get, several issues, privacy issues and everything. So all you can do is if you have problem or you want to share opinion related to something, you can use the @ option, that is the mentioned one. So as Sir already mentioned about Suresh Prabhu, so if you want to message, you want to tag him, you can tag him on your tweet. You can't message him because he's a big person and his account is managed by his manager. So he won't be able to, message you for the same. Yeah. So also you get news updates on Twitter that what is happening. So like previously while we were signing up, we had seen that we had created an interest for the same, that about the sports part or Bollywood or current news. So related to our interest, there will be a news section over here that COVID-19 in India or the trending hashtag that is going on Twitter. So suppose RRR movie is the trending one. So the hashtags that are trending are being shown on the right hand corner. So if you want, you can click more. And it will land you to the explore page itself, where you can just go down and see Zomato delivery guy. It's one of the trending in India because the case recently happened. Modi Rojgar, then Roberts. So similarly, there are a lot of tweets that or the hashtags that are trending can be shown in explore part. And if you want, you can select, yes.
Excuse me. Yes. How do you get the indication? What indication do you get if the person to whom you sent a message is replying back, or the person whom you have actually sent a @ message and he wants to reply? How do you get the indication?
So, sir, on the message tab, or you're talking about the tweet?
No, I'm saying tweet itself.
Yeah.
On the tweet, suppose somebody takes action.
Okay.
How do you know about it actually? What indication do you get? Do you get any indication
that the person has seen that particular tweet?
That action has been taken or something like that?
Yeah, so sir, the person will most likely reply in your comment section. For example, the Zomato incident happened. So if you go and write a tweet about Zomato, so they will come and reply in your comment section. Okay. So this is how you will know that they have seen it and they are going to take some action. So basically, the person who is managing their account, they come and reply to you.
But do you get a phone indication or?
Yes, you will see their comment.
Oh, so you get a phone call, is it?
No, sir. You don't get a phone call.
Yeah, sometimes it happens that they will tell you, please provide us your number or your email, and that is how they will communicate to you directly. Okay. But first, they come to your comment section and they comment there.
Okay, fine. Thank you.
So, suppose Zomato has replied to your comment, so you will get a notification that Zomato has replied to your comment.
Okay.
You will come to know that, yeah, Zomato has commented. But if Zomato has seen and not commented, we can't help it because again, privacy and all issues are there. So unlike Facebook, you come to know that people you have viewed and everything. The viewing part is not being shown and it's not being developed. only if Zomato likes your particular tweet or it comments on your particular tweet, then only you will come to know that Zomato has liked or not.
Okay, thank you.
No problem, sir. So any questions till now?
Nidhi, can I ask you that you are using a laptop or a phone?
Laptop, ma'am.
Laptop. So because your screen and the screen which I just downloaded and this thing is little different. So I was wondering, that's all.
Ma'am, are you using a Twitter app?
I have not been using. I am worried about trolls. So I was just today only before your class, I downloaded. And I have given the username. That is the handle they call. Am I right?
Ma'am. I can't hear you properly.
Yeah, it's a name. Profile name we give is our handle, right?
Yes, ma'am. Okay. So the profile name, if you see Nidhi Namani, @ Nidhi Namani. So this is my name, the profile name. Handle. So if you search for Nidhi Namani, you will get this particular profile.
Okay. Thank you.
And you can edit also. Like if there are no, like Nidhi Namani account is not there previously, or if you want to go with numbers, so you can also change. Like suppose Nidhi Namani 11 or suppose 98. So there is a 50 character limit. So you can go, but a short vertical username that is short and it's directly as your name, it's more relevant and people are easily able to search about your profile.
Okay. Thank you.
No problem. So bio is necessary as previously mentioned, and the profile and profile photo, because it helps you analyze who the person is, because there would be a lot of Nidhi in the world. But if you want, if you know that person personally, and by seeing that particular profile picture, you come to know, this Nidhi Namani I'm looking out for. I'll just click on that particular account, and if I want to follow that person, I will just click on follow. So any doubts on this particular part?
Privacy settings, we would like to know.
Okay, ma'am. I'll just go through it. So profile again. So whatever tweets that are happening will be shown here. Tweets and reply. Then the media part and the likes. So you'll come to know over here. Now in the more section, if you go, so I'll be talking about settings and privacy now. Yeah. So your, just a second. Yeah. Your account. So the account information. So whatever email address or phone number that you have been provided will be here. And you just have to confirm your password. So I'll just type down my password over here. So this is the account information that I have provided to Twitter. So my username is Nidhi Namani. If I want to add a phone number, so I just have to click on phone and add a phone number. But for now, I'm not providing phone number because again, privacy issues. So if you want, you can just opt for an email ID. Phone number is not necessary, or either way you can switch it off. Like if you are providing them with phone number, then email ID is not necessary. But it is advisable to always go for email rather than phone number, because continuously you'll start getting text of Twitters that this particular person has tweeted and everything over the text. So it's better you always go for email ID. So verified, because I'm not a famous person or something like that. So right now my account is not verified. And today only itself I've joined Twitter. So verification is not there. So it will show account creation on date what has been created. If you want to change languages, so you just have to click on languages, display language. So you can just click here, and whatever language you want your Twitter account to follow, you just have to type it over here. Suppose Spanish or something like that. So you just have to click here. Going back, gender. So if you want to mention your gender, suppose female, male, or add your gender, you can do the same. So female, so I'm saving it right now. So it will show the gender as female. Now birth date. So already the birth date is being provided. If you want, you can change it, change your birth date also. And now I'll be talking about security and account access. So if you want to go for a two-factor authentication, that suppose if I'm logging in through some other device, and like before logging and before providing my password, they are asking me for a code verification code. So I can click on two-factor verification, that what two-factor verification that I want. Like if I want to go for a text message or an authentication app. So suppose I'm going for text message. So whenever I'm logging through on Twitter through various other sources like Windows, a link, Chrome or Firefox, I can use two-factor authentication. And it is always advisable to go for the same because the hacking issue is not there yet. So even if someone is trying to hack your account, you'll come to know that your account is going to be hacked. So it's always advisable to go for a two-step verification.
Or even if someone is trying to log in from some other account, even if you are trying to log in from other device, it will give you a notification that someone is trying to log in from this device. So this is the best way to protect your account.
So these are the and notification, as previously we had put our notification as off, but we can also select that notifications quality notification. Where you want to receive your notification. So you don't follow. So if you want to mute notifications of some other people, you can select on you don't follow. So who people you don't follow, you won't see notifications for the same. So similarly, there are a lot of options that who don't follow you. So suppose I am following Narendra Modi, but he is not following me. So I won't be able to see what he tweets. So I won't get notification for the same actually. So that is who don't follow you. And someone with a new account recently who has logged in through your, I just created an account today. That is 13th March. So if suppose similarly, Sanchita also created an account today itself, so I won't see notifications for the same. So for now, I'm just clicking on these three because these three are only main. And moving further.
Excuse me.
Yes, sir.
As you said.
Yes.
If you are following a big man.
Yeah.
It's not necessary that all big people will be following you.
Correct, sir.
So if you put that notification, that setting, then you won't see actually what they are tweeting. Is that right?
Will be able to see, but you won't get a notification. Like as when I'm sending you a message over WhatsApp, you get a notification, right?
Okay.
So similarly, if Narendra Modi tweets, I won't get the notification over the phone or if I'm logging through laptop. So if you want, you can always go to his profile and see whatever he tweets.
So you can see it, but you will not get a notification.
Get a notification, right. Yeah, if you click on that.
Thank you.
So now what notification type that I want, like suppose email notification. So email notification is like someone who tweets, someone that you follow. Suppose I'm following Akshay Kumar, Anil Kapoor and Narendra Modi. So whenever they are tweeting, I'll get a notification over the email that this person has tweeted this thing. So email notification is this. If you want, you can turn it off from here. So I have email notification as off right now. If I want, I can just click over here again and it gets on. Similarly with SMS notification. So for SMS, obviously I have to provide them with my mobile number, but currently I'm not providing them my mobile number because I don't want too much notification over text messages. Email is always advisable because again, if text messages, so it's continuously your phone starts ringing and this person has tweeted on something on Twitter. So it's always advisable to go for email. And push notification is again the similarly how you get it on WhatsApp. Like suppose I'm messaging Sanchita on WhatsApp, she'll get a notification. Similarly, the push notification is something that you see over your mobile screen or your laptop screen. So if you want, you can change your languages also. Then data usage, it's a bit technical that how much data are you using. So it comes into that particular part. Ma'am, anything else you want to know about the privacy settings?
No, thanks. This was in one, just one small thing. Like, if I'm on my mobile now and I have to log out, then only I can log in laptop, because simultaneously I can't log in both, right?
You can simultaneously log
in. Okay, that's nice. Thank
you. Even if you are using an app, so it's currently with the same, I'm using an app, but it is always advisable to use Twitter and LinkedIn on a laptop, because you know, you will see a lot of things about the trending topics and all.
Yes.
Phone screen becomes really small and you won't get to see each and everything on Twitter.
Right. Thank you.
But app is basically, and Twitter and LinkedIn, are these two apps are basically made for desktop users, and app is basically to help people analyze what Twitter is and LinkedIn is. App, you can use it on a daily basis, but if you want to have an overview about it, using a desktop screen is, or tablet is, more advisable.
Okay, thank you.
No problem, ma'am. So any queries on Twitter account, like the basics, how to tweet or like, comment, retweet or anything, we can help you out here.
Nidhi,
yes, sir.
Can you tell? See, I'm still not clear because I don't have a Twitter account. So I just wanted to know, in a case of Facebook,
yes, sir.
You create friends.
Correct.
Okay. You send friends message and you create friends. So you have 100 friends, 200, whatever it is I'm talking about.
Yes, sir.
Now, supposing now you're a new entrant to tweet. Now, if you're tweeting something without tagging, I'm talking about, you're not writing @, but you are tweeting something, your own political opinion and something. This is a Zomato incident.
Correct.
Who it will not reach anywhere, isn't it?
No, sir.
Because I don't have any follower. I don't have anybody. I have just created an account and I'm tweeting my opinion on Zomato. Would it reach anybody?
So, sir, are you using any hashtags or just the normal text that we are using?
I'm not using any @.
Yeah.
I'm not using any hashtag.
So, if people who, like today I created an account, right? So, if people who are following me, suppose Sanchita is following me, she is my friend over Twitter. So, she will be able to see that that I have tweeted on this. So, if she likes my tweet, so what will happen is Sanchita's followers will come to know that she has liked this particular tweet that Nidhi has shared. So this is how the rotation goes on, and this is how your tweet will reach to other people.
So that means, but you have, sir, to create first followers.
Yes, sir.
So there are very less chances, like if you don't put @ or hashtag, there are very less chances that it will reach to people. So hashtag and @ are important.
Even if you don't want to tag someone.
No.
Yes,
my point is, because hashtag is for an existing event.
Okay.
But if you are trying to tweet on a completely new thing, there may not be a hashtag.
Correct, sir.
Then how do you reach to the people?
So what you can do is, you first, obviously today I have created an account. What I'll do is, I'll share my profile with friends and family and ask them to follow me. So what will happen... Yeah. So what will happen is, if they like my particular tweet, so their friends or their followers will come to know that Sanchita has liked Nidhi's tweet. And if they like my tweet, they can like also. Also relating to the hashtag, suppose you said it's a new event and there is no hashtag for the same. It is not necessary that hashtags are already there on your computer. You can create a new hashtag also, and which can go trending. Like suppose Zomato delivery guy was not there previously, but the hashtag was created. So you can also create your own hashtags and make it live. So people can start using those hashtags also.
Now, if I create hashtag and then tweet, whom it will reach? It will reach only to my followers, isn't it?
Followers, and if people are searching, like suppose, sir, explore, if I go on explore, and if I'm writing about sessions or workshops, suppose workshop. So people, what people do is that people search on hashtag workshop also. So if I click on hashtag workshop, I will see posts related to hashtag workshop. So what happens is, it's not necessary that only your followers will come to know. The whole world will come to know about your tweet only if, you know, if your tweet starts to reach more and more people. If it's not, then it won't make any sense to, you know, using like tweeting on a regular basis. Like workshop, right? So, sir, if I see, if I've searched for workshop, hashtag workshop, and you have used the same hashtag, so I'll see your profile over here and your particular post. And if I want to like this particular post, I just have to click here and I have liked this particular post. So whoever likes, so suppose I have tweeted about workshop, today's workshop, and Sanchita likes my tweet. So what will happen now? Sanchita's followers will come to know that she has liked this particular tweet. So this is how the circle goes on. So if Sanchita's follower has liked my particular tweet, then they will also come to know that this particular tweet is trending or this particular hashtag is trending.
And so what is advisable is to always use hashtags. If you want your tweet to reach more number of people, use hashtags. And there are hashtags for every tweet. Like even if something is going on in your mind, still you can search for hashtag and there you will find a hashtag related to your tweet.
Excuse me.
Yes, sir.
If you are having complaint about some particular shop, like for example, Domato, you are not satisfied with their service.
Yes, sir.
Now you put at the rate and then your name or whatever it is, or Zomato's name, and then you write the complaint. Now, I'm sure that the Zomato fellows will, or somebody in Zomato will definitely see it.
Sure.
And they would like to respond to it.
Correct.
Now, yes. Now that response, notification for that response will come to me.
Yes, sir.
Notification will come that yes, they have taken note of it.
Yes, sir.
And correct, perhaps the whatever action they are taking, they will write to that.
Yes, sir. So if the Zomato person comments on your particular post, or whosoever comments, like suppose I also agree with what you're posting or what you're tweeting. So okay. Whenever I comment or whenever I like your post, you commented on your tweet. Similarly with Zomato, if Zomato is commenting on your post, so you'll come to know as a notification. Or even if you open your profile, if your notifications are off, so whenever you open your Twitter account, you will see that Zomato has commented on your tweet.
Now, if Zomato wants to communicate to me personally something against my complaint,
yes, sir.
How do we get in touch with me? Or they'll make a query?
Yes, sir. So as I said before, that they will ask you for your email address or your phone number.
Okay, they will ask for it.
Yes, sir.
Thank you.
So similarly, you can reply to that particular comment. That it's the like and comment part works same as how it is done on Facebook. So everyone is like quite aware about Facebook. So how you comment on a particular post and reply. So same Twitter is there. So this is the only way you can, you know, reply to the comments or like that particular post. And if Zomato wants to get in touch with you, either he'll ask you for a mail ID or your phone number. Always, like, obviously, corporates generally go for mail ID because it is more professional.
Okay.
So any further queries related to how to set up a Twitter account and how
to... I have a query. I'm Krishna Kumar.
Yes,
like Facebook Lite, do you have Twitter Lite also? Because when you download it, it is 74 MB. So I don't want to download the entire thing. Is there a Lite?
So Twitter Lite is not there as of now, but they are going to create. But like if you don't want to use Twitter on a daily basis, then obviously just go to use your desktop and write twitter.com and log in. If you don't want to create, log in through your app. So you can just use desktop. And obviously seeing on big screen, you come to know the usage more. Even being I'm an adult right now. So I'll always prefer desktop over mobile because desktops give me a bigger view and it tells me how to go about that particular technology. So for LinkedIn and like Facebook, it is mobile friendly, Facebook and Instagram. But for professional apps like LinkedIn and Twitter, it is always advisable to go over desktop or tablet. So you will see a bigger picture and the news also trending that you won't be able to see on your phone.
Thank you, Nidhi.
No problems. So any more further questions, Oren ma'am, related to the account setup? So I will just go through the basics. Like, is my presentation visible, Sanchita? Yeah. So creating a profile, we had learned about it. Then how to follow, we have learned about it. Tweeting. Then in tweet, you can add your photo, video, or you can create a poll as well. And how to retweet. So the retweet option is already there down. And the basic functions of Twitter, the explore part, the notification, and the messages. So here again, how to like adding of profile picture. So again, it's advisable to keep a nice, inviting, and a professional quality picture as your profile photo. It looks professional also. And cover image is also advisable. Bio, as we already mentioned, it can be related to your business, position, your interest, and it should be very short and concise. So it doesn't look very, it shouldn't seem like a summary. It should be short and sweet and crisp. So Twitter, you just have to remember that you're, it's just being you. Like you can share your opinions, you can complain about things. And if you want to share some news to the world, you can use Twitter for the same. Now, examples of bio, like as we had already mentioned that you can go for business and everything. So it's just a short example. So Andrew, so he's a father. So he has written father, engaged to, and like the fiance is on Twitter. So he had tagged. And now he's interested in social media. So he has written social media, skateboarding, snowboarding, guitar. And he has mentioned that this is his Instagram account. So again, you can mention your Facebook account and Instagram account also on Twitter using the link. So any questions still here? So why should you use Twitter? Again, you will find a lot of people and it's not like if you want to follow a person, you don't have to send them a request. You can just follow them directly. So you don't have to wait for them to accept your request. You can directly follow them. So that is immediate connections also. And here the thing of group is not necessary. The group's option is not there only that much. So it's always your people are only tweeting about day-to-day news and the opinions and their interest also. And Twitter helps you. So what happens in Twitter is, suppose something is going on. Again, if you take Zomato case into consideration, the first thing was on Twitter. So in Twitter, it started trending. The hashtag started trending and people started tagging Zomato that Zomato, please look into this matter. So it's basically if you want to know about certain news, so it's just that you just have to go to Twitter and people will be talking about it already. So you'll come to know and you'll be very well aware about the particular news. And obviously it's a great way to know people and their interests and the perceptions of each and everyone. So any questions on how to set up a Twitter account so we can help you out, like if you're doing it with us simultaneously.
I think very few of us have Twitter accounts, so probably yes. People will set up later on, and if there is a doubt, we'll come back to you.
Yes, sir. Doubts will come after usage only.
Yeah. So this was the basics of.
So nicely.
Yes, sir.
Explained so nicely. Thank you so much. Now I will open my account.
If you want, like, Twitter, we can help you out still, like 5 to 10 minutes. We can wait, and you, if you want, you can set
no,
up
no,
and we can
try,
help you out.
I will try later. Thank you so much.
There was a question, how safe it is?
So again, you know already the data privacy issues are going on.
So it depends on the usage, what kind of tweets you are tweeting and everything. So it just depends.
So that is why I had mentioned that it is not advisable to go for a phone number. It is always advisable to go for an email ID, because whatever happens, you'll get it on email ID and your phone number will be safe and it won't go to other people also. So whatever data or anything, it would relate to your email ID. Or you can, if you want, you can, you know, always use a, if you, instead of personal account, you want to use your business account email ID, you can use that also, which is more safer for you. But out of phone number and email ID, always email ID is preferable, because it helps, like, even if you want to recover your account after years, so email works very fast and it is user friendly also. So phone number, sometimes you tend to change your phone number also. But there is one personal email ID that is there since yours. So you can always connect your particular account to that particular email ID.
Nidhi, if I have opened with the mobile number, now can I change it to email ID?
You can add email ID, but you can't delete the phone number, ma'am.
Oh, God.
But it's fine, because like I am also using Twitter since years, and I have provided them both with phone number and email ID, because that time even I wasn't aware about it. And there are a lot of people who are not aware, but compared to other social media apps, I guess Twitter is safe.
Okay, thank you.
Veena, you can remove that Twitter now. Then again, you install, and then in that you can put the email ID.
So you can create a separate
basically
account.
Basically, I have to delete and create a new account.
Yeah. Yes, if you want to do that.
I don't have Twitter account. I just thought of telling you, Veena. Please don't mind.
No, not at all. Thank you.
So any further questions, sir, ma'am? We